श्रीमते रामानुजाय नमः। टुडेज टॉपिक इज मोर वाइब्रेंट, मोर डायनामिक, मोस्ट एसेंशियल एंड ऑल एनकंपैसिंग। इट इज जस्ट स्पिरिचुअलाइजिंग द नेशन, nationalizing the people. So it includes nation, people, as well as the process of nationalization and spiritualization. The words are very catchy, they are very pregnant, they are very effulgent and brilliant. So it is my duty to bring up the splendor and abysmal glory of the values and polydimensional status that is hidden in these terminologies. If you say about nation, it just means the geography, topography, epigraphy and demography of a vast space. Apart from this, there are innumerable subtle instincts, emotions, their sequential impacts and their connective and multiple effects in various layers of the society, reflecting in individual, psychological, intellectual, social, cultural and international values and movements. Apart from this, if you want to say about the nationals, there are innumerable nationals. There are scholars, there are students, there are politicians, there are orators, there are Swadeshi scientists, there are technicians, there are patriots, there are commons, and there are a lot of people in the society in various settings. And in spite of lot of people crying, craving, calling and trying to integrate the same society and the umbrella of the so-called nationalism, still we find lot of gap between the practicality and theoretical exposition. And whatever we see or we hear or we read from the books and orations, that maintain a very great cleavage and distance between what we envision in the hidden dimensions of the society in the rural, tribal and downtrodden communities. This is because of various factors, and it is our duty to go into the success stories of our past and past methodologies, and for promptitude and for magnitude and multitude in our expressions, as well as the so-called desirous benefits, it is our duty to go also into failure investigations, which is the main positive factor, driver for the failure that exists in the society, maintaining a distance between the proclamations and the experiences. Number one is time factor. The time has driven the modern society to go into an endless race, so that the dedication is either transient or ephemeral or peripheral. So this time factor is the major constraint of the society by which people, in spite of having ideologies and methodologies, could not unite. Second thing is the crisis of proper direction. Each and everybody is not properly self-organized. It is just like the solidification of ice inside the refrigerator, that inside an auditorium we have here conglomerated, federated to have a solid mood, totally directed towards a particular ideology. But still, if we are being diverted to aberrant conditions, various other personal extensions, immediately our contribution and our exercises are totally scattered into innumerable pieces, and then consolidation or fortification is totally lost. So each and everybody, they require self-direction. Even though they have proclamations, they have projects, even though they have lot of statements and commitments and sentiments, but still a solid booster by which they can stand by themselves in the state and also invigorate others to commit the same, it requires lot of self-direction principles. So even though the people, they have some emotional outbursts, they are contextual, and they are very, very ephemeral in nature. So lack of proper direction in individuals. Third thing, directed people can only be led by leaderships. If these people are not properly directed, or they cannot be directed by a leadership innovation or a motivation, then it is not going to result in any use. So there is a leadership crisis. What is the type of leadership crisis? Improper leaders are there. And leadership is a chain. No leader can take you to the abode of God. Each and every leader takes you to the consecutive step, gradually you are linked with the upgrade of essence of the society. Like in the academic status, each and every teacher leads you to the other person. Leadership also, there is some immediate leadership, there is inceptive leadership, intensive leadership, transcendental leadership, ultimate leadership, all-encompassing leadership, innumerable leaderships are there in the society. There is no leadership connectivity. So, the problem with leadership is improper leadership or unorganized leadership. There is no connectivity even if we have leaders, and quarrel between the leaders instead of integrity. Fifth thing is our own zeal or awareness to become the leaders and suppress others. These qualities are the so-called envisioned qualities or pseudo-qualities of this leadership that is valued in the society has hindered the progress. That is the leadership crisis. And the fourth thing is diversion. Each and everybody is having their own problems and they are diverted in awareness and fear. They are shuffled between these instincts. Apart from which, most of the people, they are struggling for survival and establishment. They are living in life insecurity. And those people, they cannot be committed for this type of activities. So this time, dedication, leadership, personal organization and various other essential ingredients for climbing a real productive nationalism is lacking in the society, which is the main reason for the leadership to be evergreen always in words and books, not there in the practical format. So taking this into account, these qualities are to be considered on how to develop this nationalized ideology and methodology among the society is the nucleus of today's topic. Number one, there are innumerable numbers in the society. In leadership also, there are three major groups of people. One is the struggling leaders, and second is the seasonal leaders. Those who have seen a lot of things of sacrifice, those who have committed much with magnanimity, erudition, compassion, and all the other essentialities of leadership, there are seasoned leaders, maybe very few in number, infinitesimally negligible in number, there are seasonal people. And the second people, there are sleeping leaders. There are people, lot of people with sleeping qualities. The third thing is those who are having the qualities but insufficient due to organizational behavior or organizational network, those people are struggling in the society. And these people, they have to contact with five members of the society. Number one, those who are abundant in knowledge and resources. Number two, those who are sufficient in knowledge and resources. Third thing, those who are negligent in nature, those who are absent, and those who are opponents. It is told in Shastra as Samajika Panchavibhaga. So there are people who are abundant in the society, those who are sufficient, Parimita in the society, and those who are mita in the society, insufficient or negligent in society, those who totally abhava, those who don't have these qualities, and vaiparitya is opponent. So we have to meet all of these people, and if you say nationalize the people or spiritualize the society is a medley of varieties of people with various spiritual, mental, and emotional and environmental grounds. You cannot create a customized or you cannot create a generalized view or a tool for all of these people. How to deal with an abundant is different from an absent, and how to deal with an opponent is different from that of a person who is sufficient in resources. So this is the methodology. And one more thing is there. Number one, can we bring immediate impact of this thing? Number one. Number two, can we bring complete impact of this thing? Even if you bring the impact in the complete society, that is known as Purna. Second thing is immediate, Satya. Third thing is grade, Sthiti or Paristhiti. So there are three questions while asking about nationalization or spiritualization. Can we make the complete society nationalized and spiritualized? Number one. Can we make it immediately? Number two. The third thing, can we bring the same spirit of nationality or spiritualism to all people? It is not easily possible because there are a lot of people who are anticipatory in nature. They are avoiding such a leadership, such a congregation, such an association and mutual share of love and knowledge. Those people can be easily managed. And second thing is there are a lot of people who are convincible. The third thing is rationalists in the society. They must be explained and they must be induced and directed. Fourth thing is the downtrodden members of the society. Everybody, they target only at the downtrodden members of the society. Those who are totally trampled under insufficiency, paucity and total insecurity, they can be handled by any person like a doll and puppet. Politicians, theologians, converters, inverters, inhibitors of the society, they all totally concentrate on those people because they are suffering. Suffering people for the development or immediate relief, they will be obliging any sort of relief or mechanism that you prescribe. So, these type of approaches to downtrodden members, rational members and convincible members, as well as the committed, readily available members of